Hello and welcome back to another episode of Chilling and Building with Spange. And this is actually the final episode of this build. It has been a long time coming and finally bloody finished the damn thing. So this is a bit of a special episode. So I'm just going to show you guys the finishing touches here. And then I'm going to take you through how to turn this thing into an admin POI and make it so it can spawn into your random games, your normal games of Imperium. And server owners and stuff, you guys will probably already know how to add it to a POI to a planet of your choice. So hopefully this will be helpful. Anyway, the other thing that we're going to do at the end of this episode is we're actually going to have a race. So Rustimus has very kindly set up a quick server for us to do that on. We're going to just spawn it in as a POI or even as a base on a planet somewhere, and a whole bunch of us are going to jump on and we're going to start racing your wonderful creations around this track and see how it works, basically, and see who wins. But we can only have about 6 races on the track at a time, so I might montage it a bit to speed things up. I haven't decided yet. We'll see what happens. But anyway, for now, I'm just going to hand over to some tunage that I've set up for you guys to enjoy while we put the finishing touches on this thing, and then I'll come back to you in a little while and we'll turn this thing into a POI. So make sure you get yourself a brew, sit back, relax, and enjoy the build. Okay, so Akuaseka Raceway is done. It's officially done, and it is now on the workshop. Link down below in the video description. Check it out. Hit that subscribe button and go check it out for yourself. Now, I'm going to show you how to turn this thing into a POI and add it into your own custom games, your new games. The random ones that the game generates, you can add it into there. Okay, so first thing you need to do, subscribe to Akuaseka Raceway on the workshop. Again, link down below. It will appear in your blueprints list, similar to this, except it will have that icon with a little cog and the thing, not the person. Anyway, Akuaseka Raceway in a creative game. So I'm in creative now, god moding above my various collections. Just spawn that in. Okay, it doesn't need to be tidy, just pop that in somewhere like that. Okay, that's wonderful, things like that. There we go. Doesn't matter if it's underground or anything, but what we need to do is we need to swap the core out. Okay, so go into your item menu by hitting H on your keyboard and go to devices and then grab yourself an admin core. It's this blue one down here. Okay, grab one of those and then god mode your way through the floor here and you should be able to instantly see the core. Shift right click that core and the entire thing explodes. Okay. This was not part of the plan. Look at it. Excellent. Good job, game. You wanker. Bastard bloody thing. Right. Cancel that. Oh, crap. Destroy. Destroy 1130. It's good actually that I showed you that, because it means you need to do something else that I forgot you need to do. Right. Spawn that in. And then in the command, in the console, type SI space off. Structural integrity off, because for whatever reason, and it's absolutely nothing to do with the build here, half of it is bloody red and it's clearly connected to the ground all the way around. There's no reason for it to be red, it just is, because structural integrity for some reason is completely and utterly bugged at the moment and Elyon haven't fixed it. Anyway, so SI off, turn structural integrity off in the console. Now you can go through the ground. Now you can get rid of that core and everything doesn't explode. Put the admin core back, or in rather, and now it has admin powers, which means it's indestructible. The other thing to do is just go into the P menu on there. Don't worry about filling these things up, because they'll always be like that, even when you spawn it into a random game. But they will regenerate, so it shouldn't ever run out of power, in theory. The other thing you just need to check is go into the P menu, go into devices, and just double check. Now, obviously, it hasn't actually saved them here. I did do this, but it looks like you're going to have to do it yourselves, unfortunately. Sorry, it was part of the original blueprint. I don't know why it's removed it, just has. But you need to set doors, all the doors, to lock code 0000, and it's a bit of a pain in the ass, and I do apologize. If there was a way to get it to come through on the blueprint, I would. But yeah, go through all the doors, all the hangar doors, shutter doors, everything that you want to be able to access if you're on foot in a normal game, with 0000, and you'll be able to access it when it's spawned in. Things like cargo boxes as well, if you want to be able to access those. There aren't many fridges, etc., etc. You get the idea. Just set it to lock code 000, click set, and then do that for every single thing that you want to be able to access within game, and that will allow you to access it. Once that's all done, you set the lock codes, you've replaced the admin core, everything looks hunky-dory. Just bring yourself to the circuit, and then on your keyboard, it's the right alt key plus O. So right alt O to save the blueprint. Okay, what you want to do is you want to do save as. Give it a different name. So for example, I've given it the name here, Akuaseka Raceway -POI. Okay, so just do that. Save as. Put in a name, click save. It will appear red in your blueprint list. Okay, because it's got an admin core in it, it's now an invalid blueprint as far as single player normal gameplay is concerned. But that's fine. That's good. That's what you want to see. It needs to be red. Okay, once it's in here, double click it. Okay, and you get this this thing up. Now, all of this will be blank. I've done this before, so this is why it's all filled in. You need to give it a blueprint group name. That's very important. Give it something simple that's easy to remember. I've just gone for a Kuaseka RW. Blueprint spawn name is what you want it to appear as above the POI and on the map, things like that. So a Kuaseka Raceway. Blueprint ground offset, -4. Very important, because otherwise it will just appear up in the ground and the ramps won't work and things like that. And blueprint flattens ground needs to be ticked. Okay, just add all that in as is. You can change the group name if you want. You can change the blueprint spawn name if you want, but it must be -4 and it must be flattens ground. Okay, add all that in and then click set. Now you need to come out of the game and you need to go into your Imperion directory on your computer. Now the easiest way, if you don't know where that is, the easiest way to find it is go into your Steam library here and right click on Imperion Galactic Survival, go to properties, go to local files, and then browse local files, and that'll take you straight to the directory. Okay, so once you're in the directory, you'll see a content folder, you'll also see a saves folder in there. Okay, so these are the two important ones they're going to be looking at. So first of all, go to saves, blueprints, whatever that number is, and then you will see your Kuaseka Raceway POI blueprint. It'll have the name as you saved it in your blueprints. Okay, so make sure you go into the one that you saved with the admin core, not the original. Okay, so I'm going to go into a Kuaseka Raceway POI here. And we have this EPB file, okay? So it'll be the name of the blueprint.epb. We're just gonna copy that. Okay, and we're gonna go back to, all the way back to Imperium Galactic Survival here. And now we're gonna go into content. And we're gonna go into prefabs. And we're just gonna paste it into here. Okay, now, I'm going to rename it, because if you notice, this is basically these are all the prefab files. So this is all the POIs and stuff like that the game can use normally. And you notice they've all got a nice tidy naming convention. All the bases are BA something, blah blah blah, CV something, so on and so forth. So I'm going to rename it. Let me just get rid of the one I've already done. There we go. So I'm going to rename it. BA underscore Kuaseka Raceway .epb. Okay, and that's going to appear amongst all the way. It doesn't really matter what you call it. It's not that important, as long as it's something that you can find easily, I would say. I like to keep things in the same naming convention because it's neat and tidy, yeah? So rename that to BA Kuaseka Raceway if you want, but the important thing is that file needs to go in here. Okay, so now we come back out of prefabs, and this time we go into playfields, and then we scroll down and we find temperate starter. Okay, go into that, and there is a playfield underscore static dot YAML. From now on, that'll be known as YAML. YAML is YAML. Okay, so if I'm talking about YAML files, that's the sort of file I'm talking about. What you'll notice here, I've already done it, but I've taken a backup of that. So all you need to do is just copy that and then paste it into the same folder. Rename the copied to playfield underscore static dot backup. It's very important that you replace the YAML extension of the file with something else. Doesn't need to be backup, could be old, could be original, could be whatever. Make it up. Just make sure it does not have a YAML extension on it. So what I've done here is playfield underscore static.backup. I've just renamed it to that. So that one is the original, and that one is a copy of the original. Now, once you've done that, you've got your backup file, go into your original and edit that with Notepad or Notepad++, which is highly recommended because it makes it neat and tidy and easy to read. And this is where it gets a little bit complicated, so bear with me here, okay? So what you need to do is basically, let me do this YAML file here is the configuration of your starter planet. It's everything about your starter planet. It's got everything from bird flock crows, for example, where the iron resources spawn and things like that. So you could change all sorts of stuff in this, but just be careful because these files are incredibly fiddly, right? Just one like wrong space in the wrong place or the wrong comma in the wrong place and it absolutely screws up. Right. If you scroll down and you keep scrolling down and then suddenly you'll get to this POI section here. And you'll start seeing things like the junk T1, junk T2, the drone base, alien tower story, so on and so forth. These are all the POIs, okay? So these settings are all POI settings. Now what I did was I essentially copied one of these sections. Okay, so I'm going to take the crash Talos mid here. Let me just make sure, is that the right one to take? Yeah, let's take this crash Talos front here. Okay, so if we just walk through each of these lines, we can see. So we got the group name. Remember the group name from the POI when we double click the blueprint and it came up with those options. It's you could set the group name, so this is why this is important. Biomes excluded, where you don't want it to spawn is important. True, I mean it will always spawn. Count min max one is how many of that one do you want. Drone probability, drones min max, reserve count, troop transport, spawn near, and spawn near range and things like that. So what do you want it to spawn near and roughly how far away from that? And then properties, key map markers and stuff like that. So what I did is copy that entire section, including the bottom line, the empty line at the bottom. Okay, copy that. And then in that empty line at the bottom, just hit enter and then paste that. Okay, and what you should find is you have two identical spawn crash Talos front in this case. Okay, now we need to just modify it. So let's change it to spawn Akua Seka Raceway. Group name is what we called the group name, which was Akua Seka RW. Biomes excluded. Now we can leave this here. We don't want it spawning in radiated biomes, so I'm going to leave that there. Is important true? Yes, I'm going to leave that as count min max 1 1, so there only ever be one. Yes, drone probably 0. I don't want any drones on there. I do not want a min max drone, so I'm going to replace both of those numbers there with a 0 and make sure there is just one space either side of that 0. Reserve count 0, leave that as. Troop transport false, leave that as is. That means there will be no troop transports. Spawn near start, that's fine. That will spawn it near the start zone. You can remove these two lines if you don't care where it spawns. I'm going to leave them in for now because it will just make it easier to find when we actually get into the game. Properties, key, map marker, and value neutral means the map marker will appear as neutral, I guess. I don't really know, to be honest. It's got an admin core in it, so it will appear as an admin POI. Okay, and that should be it. That should be it. Because you copied and pasted that thing above there, it should be fine. Now, what I would probably have preferred to do is move this up here, so it's not cutting in between these two Talos things like that. But let's see if it works. I don't think it will matter. I think it will be fine. Certainly on the original one that I did when I was trying to figure out how to get it to work, I put it just under the drone base up here and it works. But let's see if this works. It should be fine. So once that's done and you've definitely made sure that you've got the spacing between the two sections okay, everything, just compare it to the one above basically, and everything needs to be in the same amount of lines, the same indentation, the same number of spaces. Like I said, these things are fiddly as hell. So as long as it looks like one that was already there in terms of format, and don't worry about adding extra things in if you want, you can avoid other POIs and stuff like that. Click save, basically. Save that. Okay. So that is our playfield static.yaml now. It should ignore these two because neither of those are YAML files. Let's start a new game and see what happens. Okay, so I'm just going to start the basic medium. I'm not going to fiddle with the settings because this is just a test. Okay, so once you're in your escape pod and you're descending towards a planet, you can actually start things straight away. So first of all, hit that map command. Open the console, type map. This shows objects all of where across the thing. Should see an admin POI. Yep, there it is. Found it. So it's got this chevron icon. It should be relatively close to where you start. There it is. Let's go. Well, we need to land first. Yeah, come on, escape pod. Let's go. Come on. Crash already. It's the slowest moving object in the world, really. Think about this thing hurtling down to the planet. It should be really quick. Like a bloody hot air balloon landing. Okay, let's... oh god, the Robinson Protocol interrupted me. GM to enter god mode. And then let's just... I mean, you can teleport to it. You can find the coordinates in the ents list in the console and then just teleport it to it. But by the time I typed that out, got it wrong at least once and then retyped it, I would have flown there manually. In god mode. It should just be over here. Oh, there it is. Bingo! And it spawned sort of in the woods, but it's okay. And there we go. Kurosaka Raceway is in the game, and this is just a normal single-player game. And like I said before, I mean, server owners out there and stuff, you'll be able to... You've probably done this a dozen times already with various EPB files. So you'll be able to subscribe to the item on the workshop, grab that EPB file, turn it into an admin POI, and pop that on whatever planet you want to on your own server. And there we go, it's all here, and you see it's powered up. So I don't think I can get into the P menu because it's obviously an admin core, but this should regenerate as with normal POIs according to the game options YAML. And because we did that 0 0 0 thing, if I take myself out of god mode, we can do things like switch the levers on. And we can do things like start the race. And we can do things like open doors and stuff like that. So it shouldn't be any problem if you are on a multiplayer server, getting some friends together and coming over to this thing and using it. It should all be usable. Unless, of course, you've missed out one of the doors, but these all seem to open okay. There are some things that you won't be able to access. These bathroom vanities, the closet. If you want to be able to access them, you'll have to put 000 on those as well. But yeah, it's all here. It's done. It's all yours. You can enjoy, you can race and do that. In fact, I think that's what we're going to do. So let me gather some friends of mine and spawn this thing on a little server that that Rusty has set up for us. And we're gonna race some of your creations around and we'll try and get through them all. Oh yeah, I did some advertising. You guys were calling for advertising so much in the comments. You're like, you need to do some advertising. So, I remember, like around normal racetracks and things like that, you'd have maybe like five or six brands and they'd just repeat all the way around the track. So I just come up with like three. So ASR stands for Akuaseka Raceway. That's really useful because it's just three letters. So where these blue sections were, I could just put ASR on. Whereas the normal ones that are 10 while, I come up with Steel Pike Thrusters. I thought that was quite good. Jimbo Salve, number one in salvage. Can't really see that in the sun, but yeah, number one in salvage. And Lunar Light, H engines or hover engines or hengines. Lunar Light. And as we go around, it's just repeated over and over again, all the way around. So let me know what you think. I think it looks pretty awesome. Finally, it's got some advertising on there. So branding. Okay, so, what?
I was going to say, if we're all in HVs, who's going to work the lights?
Nobody's going to work the lights. I tell you what I'm going to do, is I'm going to just kind of turn the lights to green now, okay, so there's no confusion, but we'll have to 3, 2, 1 go it, okay? All right, because, come back here, disqualified, right. Yes, hello everyone. We got all the racers spawned in here. I just want to give a quick, massive shout out to Rusty for all his hard work. Actually, putting this on the server and getting it working so that we can all come on here and play with these races. So thank you, Rusty. I really appreciate it.
No worries.
Link to his channel down below in the video description, guys. Check out his channel. Hit that subscribe button. Show him some love. All your races are here, apart from the hot dog. I didn't spawn the hot dog in because it's a hot dog and it's not a racer. So, sorry. We've lined up on the grid. We are ready to go. What we're going to do is we're going to do three laps. And we're going to try and get through all of your races as quickly as we can. And I'm not going to do anything complicated like leagues and rankings and stuff like that. No, Cal, you can't have the hot dog. We're just going to sort of go, all right, who came first? Brilliant. Move on. We haven't all ordered.
Whoever owns number 86, I apologise now. I've never, ever raced around this track yet.
86, the Gleb 76? Or is that the... No, it's the RZ Racer, I believe. RZ Racer.
Yeah, I'm not doing you any justice here.
RZ086, I believe you built that one. Right, I'm in the Spangemoto, so I'll take mine out first. And Rusty, I'm going to give you the honour of counting down. 3, 2, 1, go in your own time.
3, 2, 1, go!
I just crashed into the back of you. Oh my god.
Oh,
oh, he's taking someone. I'm on your tail, Static. Yeah, bitch, have that.
You better pass me. God.
He's out in front. Is somebody out in front? He took a shortcut. That's all right. It's bite. Catching bite. Oh, I'm lagging. Got some lag. Lap one. Oh, he's crashed into the wall. Ah, Span is in pole. Come on. Let's go. Spangemoto is the best hover here. Of course.
Bite, stop taking up the track. Come on. How many laps are we doing?
Just three. Should be on your second one by now.
God damn it, Spangemoto's too good at this.
I've had a bit of practice, to be fair. Third and final lap.
Just around the third lap, really?
There's a part of this track where I always seem to go backwards.
Is that on that really nasty, like, chicane into the hairpin chicane? Oh, I'm about to lap someone.
Consistently backwards.
It's the RZ. Oh, Fishy. It just crashed into Fishy. Hang on, I'm mounting Fishy now. Hang on. Oh, dear.
At least set me up for a drink first.
Yeah. Sponge wins, obviously.
Oh, I've only just started my third lap.
Yeah.
That was bad. Am I supposed to complete my third lap?
Taking a resounding third.
What on stake?
It seemed a little bit easier to deal with
everything. Now, has anybody got an hourglass to wait for the rest of them?
I'm coming.
I'm sure they'll be here in a second. Right. Alright, so if you finish the race, come out and park up and grab another racer. So, Spangemoto won that one, obviously.
Fixed.
Okay, I'll let someone take Ionix Racer, because Ionix Racer is actually quicker than mine. So that's this one with 84 on this one here. Ionic, he's got the lap record at the moment.
Kind of want to take Chiefs.
Take Chiefs, yeah. Lucifer's is also very quick. This one here, which looks like a bike. Again, line up on the grid.
Sorry, Chief.
You guys finished. Yeah.
I'll take Penelope pit stops.
The Galeb 76
round, yeah. No, we haven't used that one. Take that one, yeah, that's good.
Okay, that's Martin then.
Ionix is really fast.
Yeah.
The acceleration is horrendous.
It's actually very nice to drive as well. When you're on the track, it is just very good.
What's that like look of? Oh, I love
nothing. Has that one got fuel in it there, bite?
I have to be at the front.
Yes, and it seems to be phenomenally fast, actually.
Do we actually have a place to park the ones that have already completed so we don't keep taking the same ones?
No.
I ditched that one outside.
No, it's just generally a memory exercise at this point. Yeah, it's a good idea. Let's ditch them off the track. If we've raced them, just park them off the track. That's a good idea.
Is anybody else getting the you're at 3 meters but you're still on the ground bug?
Yeah, that does happen, unfortunately, if there's nothing between the core and the ground. You've just got to drive it around a bit until it comes unstuck.
The problem is I can't get it to move.
Oh, there you go. Hang on, let me move Team Paul Blokes Racer. In fact, I'll take it. There you go. Nope.
Fish, you finished our 3 laps.
Right, is that everybody? Hang on. What else? Bites one, that one's done. Let's take that one off the track.
Ionic, I apologize now. I hope it goes backwards as fast as it goes forwards.
There's this little blue one. That was raced, wasn't it? The blue arrow?
Yeah, I did the blue arrow last lap.
Okay, I'll take that off the track. Alright.
This Nosh cart is beautiful.
Right, I'm going to try.
It's nice. It's heavy, though. Just be...
It's not going to go anywhere.
It's not bad. It just takes a little getting used to. Right, everybody's lined up.
I'm wondering how this one's going to work, because it's got really good rear thrust and really good side thrust, but barely any reverse thrust.
That's fine. Just drift it. Drift it like a boss, right? You will need to move forward a bit, Bite. Come to me.
It's all about that sweet Tokyo
drift. Back up a bit. Back a bit. There you go. That'll do. Everybody else is all good. Right. Fishy, do you want to count us down in this one?
I'd love to. 3, 2, 1, go.
Go.
When you said one.
Oh, that was mean.
it's Chief's Razor. It's me and Stack. Oh, hello.
I'm just going to give up now.
You just got to put that one in a heavy drift.
Auto break off.
Keep it in the wall, and then it just like snaps my camera.
Oh no. It's that lag. Oh, it just hit the wall. Come on, Team Paul Bloke Racer. You can do it.
Come on, Chief, don't let me down.
It's a bloody good little racer, that one. Panther 2. I hit the wall. Gotta get the drift on.
It's
right on your ass.
Stay away!
Someone just lapped me.
No, that's me, I think.
I'm going back. He was Slayton. So neck and neck. God. No, I just clipped you and it stopped me.
That's two.
There's three.
Final lap.
Final lap. Come on, Team Paul Blake Racer. Let's go.
Ah,
what the hell? You're stuck on your ass.
No.
Ah!
She's over.
I'm upside down.
Checkered flag is out.
You're upside down.
Chief takes it.
Ah, oh, damn. Team Blue Blade, they were so close. What happened, Fishy? What happened? You're upside down.
Hello.
we need a recovery car.
Yeah. My career is over.
That's a fiery death. There's the Galeb 76.
Unless anybody else has crossed my second.
No, I took second, dude. It was Chief's Panther and then Team Paul Blokes Racer second. I think that makes you third, Bite.
You want a boost here? Stay there, ready? I'm gonna see if I can get underneath you.
I think I might have set a record for number of crashes.
That's a pretty tricky record. Who was in Ionic's racer there?
Me.
You should be ashamed of yourself. You should have been first.
No, sorry, Ionic. It's so unbelievably quick, though.
It's so fast.
It's basically accelerating to a wall. It's good fun.
Yeah.
Well, whoever's in the mash car is stuck in it. Because I can't get you out.
They could get him out. They have to cut him out.
Let's have a look.
No, no, you're going the wrong way. Come on, you can get it home. Come on, Fishy.
Alright, okay, okay. I've got this. I've got this.
You got this.
Has anyone
Deja vu.
The Dart Hover Racer. Whose is that?
I can't remember whose the Dart is.
About 6,000 thrusters on the back.
Yeah. 20,000 thrust. Under
the
sea.
Tank.
Take the tank. That's Jen's.
Alright, Jen. Sorry.
Yeah.
Where's Lucy's? Did anyone take Lucy's yet?
No, Lucy's is here.
Which one's Lucy's?
This one. I'm above it now. Static's got it.
Static's. Alright.
I'll try to do your prayer, Luce.
Ah, the line.
The five line. Actually, I haven't tried this one because this is. He's just updated it. It looks a lot slimmer than what it was. So.
Okay, yeah. I am not losing to a tank.
Yeah.
I bet.
That tank is ready to go for the death race mode, that is.
It is.
That's what I'm talking about. Alright, everybody's got a hover. All right, I've got to pick one now. And we're down to just three left. I'll take the red one.
Yeah.
Whoa,
whoever
okay.
Whoever made the cat whisker, I'm sorry, I'm going to embed it in a wall. Just like the other two.
Pretty standard. Alright. Static, do you want to count us down on this one?
Sure. Everybody
can ready? I have a lap for free?
Alright, 3, 2, 1, go. Move, tank, move!
Oh my god! I just mated with something. I don't know what it was.
Oh, for God's sakes.
Oh, get up the ramp! Oh, does that mean I'm first?
Jesus!
This thing's alright.
Oh, just keep crashing into the tank.
This thing's alright. This thing is quick.
I'm stuck on the wall there.
Oh shit, there's the pit lane.
Get this tank out of my way! I flipped. I hit the tank and I flipped.
I think the track
is
just one block too thin.
Yeah.
Maybe expand it out one block.
No. I mean, if you want to. By all means! Let me know how long that takes. Oh my god, I'm gonna lap someone.
I've finally done a lap.
Probably me.
I'm on lap 3 already. Third and final lap.
Just like to say to Jen, thanks for putting headlights on it. Because it's almost night time.
Oh, I took the cat whisker there with no trouble whatsoever. Come on, baby. Oh, God. It really doesn't do collisions very well.
Alright, Luce, I just passed somebody after flipping once. Oh, God, no! I flipped again!
There's the five line. There's... Oh, right, my stack.
Don't get lapped.
Yes, you got lapped. Winner!
Jesus.
He was in a cat whisker because I just saw that.
This thing was awesome.
Cat whisker just landed out in the lobby. I think we're just going to park it here. We're on the patio.
Whoever,
I'm going for a beer.
Whoever was in the tank.
Dart Hover, man. This thing is awesome.
It was driving the... Who's driving the five line?
That's me.
You managed to crash into me 4 times.
I'd say you crashed into me first, actually.
Yeah, we all crashed into each other. There's much crashing going on. Alright, we've got 2 left.
I was driving the tank. I started, and then I hit them, and then they crashed into me later on and flipped me.
I tell you what, the tank's really good. I enjoyed that.
It's a beast.
Very well balanced. Like it.
Right, we've got 2 left, so if 2 of you jump into one of the remaining ones, and then everybody else just take whichever one you want. I'm going to take one I haven't raced yet.
Hey, if anybody wants, they can take the cat whisker. It's only parked in the lobby. It's got 1 lap on it.
Where is that thing? What did you do with it?
Like a flying car from Back to the Future. This is
parked. Awesome. Oh my god, it's up here. How did you do that? That's just brilliant.
You know, that collision on that corner, you get hit the right way coming around there at the full throttle, and that's it. You're done for.
Yeah, yeah. It's quite heavy, the old cat whisker.
You want it to be as short as possible and have good rear, side, and front thrust.
Right, you got to do Ionix Racer proud because that thing is stupidly quick. Right.
Whoever designed the Zinx.
Alright, I'm ready to go.
Hang on, let me grab one. Who should I take?
Take the fish.
Take the fish.
Okay, I'm on foot. I'm ready.
I'm in the racer I want to be in.
Oh my god, right, okay.
My racer spawned in and he never spawned it in. I'm really bummed out.
It has too many RCSs.
This disqualified. One's not legal?
No, it's not.
What?
Oh. Get out of here.
Hey,
Spans,
you want to drop a motorbike?
I really do, actually.
Yeah,
I think that would be hilarious.
Okay, Mom.
I'll take a motorbike. That'd be.
is a motorbike?
Oh, you gave it to somebody. Oh,
there's another one. There you go.
That one.
All right, I'll take the last hover that's left over then. Pod Racer Mark II! This thing set a hell of a lap time as well. So it's all good. Alright. Alright.
I'm in the Zinx.
The Zinx.
The Zinx.
X-I-N-X.
Alright.
Oh, very good, very good.
Cow, do you want to count us down?
On your marks. 2, 1, go, go, go!
What?
Oh, God!
I think I might have false started. It's fine, nobody was watching.
You know, I like, every time I get in front of an HV, they drive through me.
I like. Oh, crap. Oh, bike's just taking me!
I've been in the lead the whole time, nobody's gone past me.
There you go, we've just got past you.
No! I'm not losing to you,
Cam! Damn it! Just
whacks it. Whee! I like this thing. This thing's good.
I need better side thrust.
One lap down.
Get that drift on. Get that drift on. That is some serious drifting. Chilling and drifting.
Oh, I almost had you then.
Hello, Mr. Bike. Who's on that? Third and final lap. Well, halfway round, third and final lap. Oh, got another bike. How is that Ionic Racer not up my chuff right now?
It's
winner!
Lap 2!
Lap 2!
I'll take another second.
Well done, bite. Good race.
I just got run over by a pod racer and I can't.
There's the Ionic Racer, finally. Gah. It's not the racer. It's not the race.
Exactly. Yeah,
it's the pilot. There's the Cadillac.
It's not the car, it's the driver, I'm telling you.
Right. Let's put these hovers back and let's have a bike race. Just for lols.
Yeah, the motorcycles are a little bit of a pain in the ass to get around here because it turns wider than the track.
Yeah, you gotta slow down then, didn't you?
Just to say, there is a Mark III of this, which I didn't actually quite have ready. The Mark II of this isn't actually the up-to-date version, and I think the up-to-date version might stand a chance of winning this. Spange, I don't... Oh, right, yeah.
Everybody got a bike? Who's that out front? Come back. Put yourself on a grid, like proper.
I just had to finish lap three there. Hold on.
This is where I am. All right, you can go there if you want. Go there.
This is where I started last.
Yeah. All right, bye. Count us down.
3, 2, 1, go.
It's the MotoGP of Kuzik Raceway. Oh my god, there's so much lag. I don't know where I am anymore.
How is it that there's more lag on motorbikes than in hover vessels?
Because motorbikes are just broken.
Because motorbikes are so OP, bro.
Yeah. Oh my god. I am doing the worst at this.
You have to really take the corners on this, don't you?
Oh yeah.
No, you're not.
Whee!
Discovered a POI.
Someone just pulled ahead of me.
That's what she said.
Does that even make sense?
I don't know.
Did she said she discovered a POI, or she said she pulled ahead of you?
She pulled out of me. That was the
she pulled out of you? That's interesting.
Well, you know, I have an avid and...
I gotta fix the camera every now and then.
Yeah. Lap 2! You're just driving sideways on my screen.
So are you, and somehow you stop me from going.
These bikes are the worst ever.
Oh god, I'm in a wall.
Come on, yes! What's that, second? I don't know. Ah!
I'm not even on that three.
I just hit fishy and stopped instantly.
Lap three!
Oh, what the hell? Everybody's so far ahead of me.
Oh, I'm right behind whoever's at first.
Lap three.
I was.
Lap 3.
Oh crap, that's a wall. I just got overtaken by Rusty.
You've all just soldered it off.
Oh, I passed whoever's in first! Let's go! Yeah,
gosh, hit the wall. Bastard.
Get
back here.
Yep.
Oh man.
Let's go! First place!
In
the only race that counts!
Man, I did dismally bad on that one. Oh, my fifth. Amazing. Oh, there we go. Who hasn't finished yet?
Me.
Poor bite. Poor bite is somewhere in a Kuzik race. We don't know. We'll have to send out search teams.
Come on, Grandma.
That was funny.
Bite went to find cat whiskers.
Here he comes.
And across the line in only 5 hours.
Hey!
You should have did it on foot, but there, bite, you probably wouldn't have ran faster.
Brilliant stuff. Alright, there we go, guys. That is Kuzik Raceway. Link down below in the video description, all yours to enjoy. Download it now, and you can add it to your single player games, you can add it to your multiplayer servers, and you can have all this kind of fun with it. So hope you guys enjoy, and thanks for watching this series. Remember, next week I am starting a brand new series of In Chilling and Building on Twitch. So again, link down below in the video description. And they're all killing each other now, so that's
everyone got machine guns.
Ah, come on, who killed? I can't even take these guys anywhere.
I don't even have a gun.
Brilliant. Thanks very much for watching, everyone. Thanks for watching the series. Hope you enjoyed. Hopefully I'll see you next time. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.